about to launch what's thought to be the first graffiti art course in Europe. Students will work in crews, just like the American street gangs that started the style. Clarence Mitchell now reports.
It confronts every town and city dweller. It invariably offends. In the main, it's illegal, and it gives youngsters a reputation for mindless vandalism. But in Scarborough, it's all beginning to change. At least 8 graffiti murals like this one now adorn the town, all of them permitted and actually commissioned by the site owners. Inspired by the art of American street gangs, they've been done by students who are now about to start the new graffiti art course. With lectures from the police and Greenpeace, the idea is graffiti, but with social responsibility.
What we're doing is a very short 10-week course, which will give people 20 hours tuition. I believe it will give them the basics of handling graffiti in a responsible and commercial way. If you're looking at this as an educational venture, which the college is, once people get to the stage that they can earn a living and satisfy a demand, those are the two criteria they're looking at, I think it's quite possible that this could become a specialised form of graphic design.
18 students are lined up, most aiming for careers in art and graphic design. The aerosols they'll be using won't damage the ozone layer. The police will advise them on legality. The course will tackle several commissions, including promotional work for Frankie Lane the musician. Most painting will be done on boards rather than walls, but there's one big hitch.
The big problem is that on the 26th of September the course, I hope, is going to start, but what the problem we've got is that we haven't got any premises, we haven't got a classroom. What we need is a warehouse, a small warehouse, or a garage, or a yard that's undercover for 15 people.
As the hunt for a home continues, the college stresses it's encouraging responsible art, not more vandalism. It's also one of the brightest ways to liven up old buildings, and usually, once they're painted, the illegal graffiti never returns.
Colourful anyway. I think some of that looks rather fun. I wonder if one Kilroy has enrolled on the course.
I bet. Well, that's about it from Judith and me. We'll leave you with more magical moments in Seoul as Adrian Morehouse celebrated his famous victory.